This week on Maker Update, a compact Rubik's robot, dog armor, doomsday lamps, gift TVs, and a Peloton for TikTok. Hey everybody, I'm Donald Bell and welcome back to another Maker Update. I hope you're all doing well and maybe have some fun stuff planned for the summer. I'm gonna keep it quick this week, but I have a lot of fun stuff to show you, so let's get started with the project of the week. On Instructables, Andrea Favero shows how he made this ingenious Rubik's Cube solving robot. I've shown a few different cube solving robots on this channel before, but this one has a few things that make it notable. First, it's tiny. It's not much bigger than the cube itself. Part of what's turned me off about projects like this before is that it seems a little absurd to have a 3D printer-sized machine to solve a tiny toy puzzle. The second noticeable difference is that the robot grip mechanism is so simple. Really, that's what allows the design to be so compact. You have this hood that drops down to hold the top two layers in place while the bottom layer twists. The same hood, when tilted back beyond its open position, acts as a little foot that flips the cube over into a new position. And finally, the design is almost entirely 3D printed, making it easy to replicate. And again, because the design is small, it won't take you days to print and fit all the parts. For the electronics, Andrea is using a Raspberry Pi 02 along with a Pi camera module that scans each side of the puzzle. There are two nice metal servos, one for the lid and one for the twist action on the base. And one of my favorite touches is the display on the side that communicates each step in the puzzle solving process. You can find everything you need to recreate this project using the link in the description. Now for some news. This Friday, June 10th, is the return of the NYC Resistor Interactive Showcase in Brooklyn. Becky Stern is helping to organize it, and this year's theme is the Cursed Technology Shop. There are over two dozen contributing artists, and it should be a lot of fun. I'll leave a link to the event page down in the description. More projects. Martina at Nerdforge has a fun and entertaining video on how she made this Viking-inspired leather armor for her dog. The dog is a really good sport here, allowing her to fit the pattern and make adjustments. Martina also shows some great techniques for giving leather a metallic look, both with paint and a high gloss coat. If you could use a smile, don't miss this video. On Hackaday, we're seeing some great eco-focused projects come through for the Hackaday Prize. One that really caught my attention was this small, solar-powered LED lamp by Peter Misenko. He calls this the Doomsday Light, in part because it's designed to last a long, long time. Instead of charging up a conventional lithium-ion battery, which would eventually lose its ability to hold the charge, this design uses a supercapacitor. The combination of capacitor and step-up converter also allows the power to drain down to 0.3 volts before shutting off. I also like these six fancy photodiodes he's using, which are easier to sprinkle into a board design than a clunky solar cell, and are apparently more resilient against damage. Over on Adafruit, there's a fun animated GIF player project created as part of a collaboration between the Ruiz brothers, Kattni, Rembor, and Liz Clark. I like the vintage TV set 3D printed enclosure, and inside you'll find a Feather RP2040 board, a rounded rectangle display for that vintage TV look, a rechargeable battery pack, and a slide switch. You'll need to optimize the size of the GIFs to get them to work, but what's great is that all you'll have to do is drag them to the board to get them installed. And finally, check out Eric Guidry's TikTok scrolling exercise bike. By outfitting his stationary bike with a Hall effect sensor, an Arduino, and a few buttons by the handlebars, Eric is able to scroll his TikTok feed and even like videos with the press of a button. If the bike stops or goes too slow though, the buttons are disabled. It seems like a clever way to harness social media habits for real-world benefits. If TikTok's not your thing though, Eric's system seems like it could be adapted to other software. Now for some tips and tools. On Hackaday, I saw this interesting 3D printed Flexure design by Topias, Korpi. Using a dial indicator on one end and a screw on the other to apply force, you get to see how this particular arrangement of print and place flexure joints creates a roughly 15-to-1 reduction between the two elements. There's a Thingiverse link for printing your own, but really, It's meant to inspire you to explore flexures and make something useful for you. On YouTube, Caleb Kraft has a guide for creating your own print-in-place mechanical iris. Caleb is no stranger to mechanical iris designs. He's made a bunch, big and small, but the idea of making a print-in-place design where everything works just right off the printer bed was something he wanted to try. In this 15-minute video, you get to see Caleb's entire design process in Fusion 360, including all the little tips and tricks for engineering something to work as a print-in-place design. Of course, if you just want to download the design and play with it, he's included a printables link for printing your own. And if you enjoy the tips and tools section of this show, be sure to check out Gareth Branwen's Tips, Tools, and Shop Tales newsletter. This past week, he had a great one that took a look at vertical tool drawers, marking codes for surface mount components, cleaning brushes with a wire wheel, and more. You can find a link to it down in the description. For this week's Digi-Key Spotlight, check out their video on how to repair broken traces on a circuit board. This is a good skill to know about for fixing up old boards that may have peeling traces. It's also a good skill for hacking or deliberately rewiring boards where you need to cut traces on purpose to make it do what you want. Check it out. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment if you want. Get on the Maker Update email list if you want to see what I'm giving away this week as part of my workshop purge. Big thanks to Digi-Key Electronics for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.